Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ, and today I'm going to talk about the Doe app. Now, the Doe app is a free investment app, a free trading app, which is currently only available as a mobile app available on iOS as well as Android. And so you can't trade online, you can't use a website, but you can use your iPhone or your Android device to invest using the Doe app. Now, as I mentioned, the Doe app is free. There is no charge when buying or selling a stock. And not only can you buy and sell stocks for free, but they also offer options trading. Now, for options trading, in order to be eligible, you need at least $250 in your account in order to trade options. That is the minimum in order for that to be activated. But there are also some other requirements, which when you first set up your account, you have to let them know how advanced you are or how knowledgeable you are about trading and your experience in order to be eligible for options as well. And so options is an advanced trading strategy, which allows you to essentially make projections on what you think a stock is going to do over a certain period of time. And that could be a call option, which is where you're saying that you believe a stock is going to go up to a certain price over a certain time period, whether it's a week or a month or a year in advance. Or it could be a put option, which is essentially shorting a stock or projecting that a stock will lose value over a certain time period, whether that's a week, a month, or a year. But not only that, with options trading, you can actually make money even if the stock doesn't have a lot of movement, whether up or down. And so there are different trading strategies with options trading that allow you to make money no matter what an individual stock does. As long as you select the right strategy over the right time frame, you can actually make money with options no matter what. But you can also lose money as well if you don't get the correct direction and the correct time frame in order for those trades. And that's why this is more of an advanced trading strategy. It is meant more for people who have a little bit more knowledge about investing to make those types of trades and to also reduce some of their risk by having some downside protection for any of the stocks that they may be holding. And if you don't actually know how to trade options, this is one of the reasons I do like the Doe app, is that they actually have content to actually teach you and help you learn more about the stock market as well as trading options on their platform. And so within the Doe app, just like many other investment apps, you'll have access to news and current events, but the Doe app has actual podcasts and actual information to help you with your trading or to let you know some of the behind the scenes of, you know, when there's a big event, like with GameStop recently, they kind of give you some of that background information to tell you, you know, why things happen or how things happen, and to kind of help you trade options, help you with your buy and sell decisions without giving you actual individual investment advice, just letting you know how the stock market works. And so with a lot of free trading apps, they try to give you additional features and information, but I really like the content that they have on the Doe app, which is why I wanted to do a review of this specific app. And so I've actually listened to a few of their podcasts, some of their content within the app. And so far I've liked what I've heard. And so I think this would be very useful to many people, whether you're a new investor or if you're an advanced trader and you want to learn some additional advanced strategies. And so a few of the segments that they have on the Doe app, there's a segment called social currency. And that's essentially when they'll talk about things that are happening in social media or things that are happening in the news. And you know, it's a play on words, social and currency. You're investing, it's money, ha ha ha. But also they have a segment that they do every day that's called Trading with Strangers. And so every day at 12 Central, they actually live stream and it's the actual CEO of the company. And one of the people is actually the CEO. His name is Victor Jones. He is actually on the podcast. He's talking with you every day. Not sure how long he's going to do that, but at least now in the past couple of years that the app has been available, he is actually front and center and participating and helping to provide the content. And so there aren't many apps out there where you actually get engagement from the CEO or the creator of the app on a daily basis. So that's something I really like about it as well. You're in contact with the people who are actually at the top within this specific company for this specific app. And so all of this is something that really stands out as far as the investment apps that I've used and that I've tried, is that they have a lot of content. And so people that are new to investing, I would definitely recommend trying out the Doe app. You're going to learn a lot if you were to listen to their podcast, if you were to read their content. It's really good content. And of course, it's a free trading app. Even if you don't trade on a daily basis, you can still use it for the content as well. But maybe you'll learn something, especially with options trading. They actually have their own options boot camp. So they give you a step-by-step process in not only explaining how options work, but showing you how it works with actual videos on their YouTube channel. Now, a few things that are actually missing from the app as far as apps that I've used and that I like to use for investing is that currently they don't offer the ability to invest in fractional shares. If you're a person that doesn't have a lot of money to invest, being able to invest in fractional shares allows you to get into larger or higher priced companies like maybe a Tesla or Amazon, or companies that, you know, it may be a couple of $100 just to buy one share of stock. And they also currently don't allow you to set up recurring purchases. So if you wanted to invest just a little money, and this is usually a feature that is brought on once a company has fractional shares, you could set up a schedule to where you're investing a little bit of money each day or each week or each month. And so this app, I believe it's only been available for 2 years. An app like Robinhood, which has been available for over 5 years, they just got some of those features last year. And so I would expect over time that the Do app will add more features as they get more users and more participants and more engagement with their investment app. But even without those things, it essentially has everything that you need. It's a free trading app. It offers options trading if you want to do a little bit more of advanced trades. And just like many other free investment apps or new apps in general, they offer something free when you sign up. And so if you use my referral link, you will actually get one free share of stock valued up to $500. And if you were to deposit at least $100 after you sign up, there will be an option to receive a second free share of stock. So make sure you use my referral link and make sure you deposit at least $100 when you do sign up so that you can get that second free share of stock. And so I do plan on doing a walkthrough or a step-by-step tutorial of the Do app in the future. But based on what we've talked about today, the basic features of the app, is this something that you would use? How do you like it compared to other free trading apps? Actually recently did a video for some of the best Robinhood replacements, and the Do app was one of those apps that I put in that video, but you can check that video out as well. For those of you who are already Do app users, let us know what you think about the app and let us know your experience in the comment section below. Based on this video, if you're not already a Do app user, is this something that you would use based on the features that I talked about today? And what do you think about having that podcast or YouTube content that is already within the app, something that's going to help you learn about the stock market, learn about trading individual stocks or trading options, and just giving you a way to learn more and be more knowledgeable about investing all in one app versus getting that information from multiple places? So just let us know what you think in the comment section below. All right, thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate you taking this time out of your day. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is hit the subscribe button down below, hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video just like this. Again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.